I am Aligarh Lingappa, Assistant Professor in Physics. Today's my branch is Electricity, Vector and Electromagnetic Theory branch, Semester 3, BSc Third Semester, Paper 3.1. My chapter name, so Electromagnetic Theory, a topic Ampere's Circuit Law, Wave equation for field vectors. Electricity, vector and electromagnetic theory, program BSc, subject physics, semester, third semester, university, Krishna Devaraya University, Vijayanagara Sri Krishna Devaraya University, Bellary, session 45. Learning objects, magnetic field density, electric field vector, permeability of free space, electric current, Boyer-Savart's law. So these are the learning objective for the study of Ampere's circuit law and a wave equation for field vectors. Session outcomes. A relation between the magnetic field and current, magnetic effect of an electric current, a specific space-time behavior, Maxwell's field equations. So prerequisites for the study of Ampere's circuit law, we must know certain things: electric field vector, magnetic field vector, electric field intensity, vector identities, permeability of free space. Ampere's circuit law. Then what about the statement and explanation of Ampere's circuit law? It states that the integral of magnetic field density along an imaginary closed path is equal to the product of current enclosed by the path and permeability of the medium. So line integral to the magnetic field of the car, which is equal to mu naught times the current passing through it. So the integral of magnetic field density along an imaginary closed path, that must be equal to the product of current we enclosed by the path and permeability of the medium. So it is mathematically expressed as integration of B dot dl, which is equal to mu naught I, where a B vector, that indicates a magnetic field density, and dl, so that means current carrying imaginary conductor. Mu naught is the permeability of free space, I is the net current enclosed by the loop. So then what about the proof of Ampere's law? Consider a long straight conductor carrying current I perpendicular to the face in upward direction as shown in the figure. So just let I be the current flows through the conductor. Then let us consider an imaginary circular path, that means enclosed path, where R be the radius, let dl be the small elements of the circular path, let P be the point, where B is the magnetic field at point P, so tangential to the circular path, as shown in the diagram. From Boyer-Savart's law, the magnetic field at any point P, which is at a distance R from the conductor, which is given by B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi R. Then the direction of magnetic field at point P is along the tangent to the circle of radius R, with the conductor at the center of the circle. For every point on the circle, magnetic field has same magnitude as given by B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi R. and a field is tangent to the circle at each point. The line integral of B around the circle, that means integral of B dot dl, which is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r into dl, which is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r into integration of dl. Since integration of dl, which is equal to the total length of the imaginary closed path, which is equal to 2 pi r, so called circumference of the circle. So then the above equation becomes integration of b dot dl, which is equal to mu naught I. So this is the same method of the Ampere's law, that is the statement of Ampere's law. This Ampere's law is true for any assembly of currents and for any closed curve, through we have proved the result using a circular Amperean loop. So we know that Maxwell's field equations, del dot E, which is equal to rho by epsilon naught, divergence of E, which is equal to rho by epsilon naught, so that means according to Gauss law, del cross E, curl of E, which is equal to minus delta B by delta T, Faraday's law, del dot B, which is equal to zero, absence of magnetic field, monopoles, that means the divergence of B must be equal to zero. Then curl of B, del cross B, which is equal to mu naught J plus epsilon naught mu naught delta E by delta T, Maxwell's Ampere's law. Derivation of electromagnetic waves from Maxwell's equations. We will assume that the vectors for the electric and magnetic fields in an electromagnetic magnetic wave you have a specific space-time behavior that is consistent with the Maxwell's equations. Assume an electromagnetic wave that travels in the x direction as shown in the figure. The x direction is the direction of propagation. Then electric field is assumed to be in the y direction and the magnetic field is in the z direction. Just to see the diagram. So called, that indicates the propagation of electromagnetic waves. Assuming that the electromagnetic wave which propagates along a x direction, where E that indicates the electric field vector and B that indicates the magnetic field vector. So basically electromagnetic wave associated with the magnetic field vector and electric field vector, where electric field vector and magnetic field vector is vibrating mutually perpendicular to each other and also perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave. So as shown in the diagram. So then a field equations in a free space, divergence of E that must be equal to 0, del dot E is equal to 0, del cross E which is equal to minus delta B by delta T, curl of E. So divergence of B is equal to 0, delta dot B is equal to 0, curl B, delta del cross B which is equal to mu naught epsilon naught delta E by delta T, so called, these are the Maxwell's field equations in a free space. These are the general Maxwell's equations specialized to the case with the charge and the current both such to zero. Taking the curl of the curl equations gives del cross of del cross E which is equal to del cross minus delta B by delta T which is equal to minus del by del T of delta by delta T of del cross B which is equal to minus mu naught epsilon naught delta square E by delta T square. So then del cross E of del cross B, curl of curl B which is equal to del cross del cross mu naught epsilon naught delta E by delta T which is equal to mu naught epsilon naught delta by delta T of curl E del cross E which is equal to minus mu naught epsilon naught delta square B by delta T square. Then we can use the vector identity, curl of curl V, that means del cross of del cross V which is equal to del of del dot V which is del dot v minus del square v, where v is any vector function of space, and then del square v, which is equal to del dot del v. Then divergence of E is equal to 0. That means del dot A is equal to 0. Del dot B is equal to 0. That means divergence of B is equal to 0. Then the first term on the right in the identity vanishes, and we obtain the wave equations. 1 by C naught square delta square E by delta T square minus del square E is equal to 0. 1 by C naught square delta square B by delta T square minus del square B is equal to 0. Where C, C naught, which is equal to 1 by root of mu naught epsilon naught, which is equal to 2.99792458×10⁸ meter per second, the velocity of electromagnetic waves in a free space. From Maxwell's equations applied to empty space, the following partial derivatives can be found. Delta square E by delta X square, which is equal to mu naught epsilon naught, delta square E by delta T square, and delta square B by delta X square, which is equal to mu naught epsilon naught, delta square B by delta T square. These are in the form of general wave equation with V is equal to C is equal to 1 by root of mu naught epsilon naught. Substituting the values of mu naught and epsilon naught gives C is equal to 2.99792×10⁸ meter per second. So called velocity of wave in a free space. Application of Pierce's law has many practical applications. The main uses is of course calculating the magnetic field generated by an electric current. This is useful in electromagnets, motors, generators, and transformers, etc. Ampere's law simplifies the calculation process by using a certain symmetry. It is used for the study of the magnetic field of a long straight conductor carrying current. So, long straight current carrying wire. It is used to study of the magnetic field due to long current carrying solenoid. So these are the, I think, applications of Ampere's law. The main use of this is calculating the magnetic field generated by an electric current. This is useful in electromagnets, motors, generators, transformers, so etc. So this can be used to simplify the calculation process by using a certain symmetry. It is used for the study of the magnetic field of a long straight current carrying wire. It is used to study the magnetic field due to a long current carrying solenoid. So now we have discussed about multiple choice questions. If a coil carrying current is placed in a uniform magnetic field, then EMF is produced. A torque is produced, force is produced, torque and force is produced. Then which one is the correct answer? So torque is produced. The point from form of Ampere's law is given by a curl of B is equal to I, curl D is equal to J, curl V is equal to I, curl H is equal to J. So fourth one is the correct answer. The Ampere law is based on which theorem? Green's theorem, Gauss divergence theorem, Stokes theorem, Maxwell's theorem. So Ampere's law is based on Stokes theorem. Fourth one. In Ampere circuit law, what is the purpose of an Amperean path? A computation of magnetic field intensity. A determination of differential element of path length, estimation of electric flux density, a detection of loop in a constant plane. So, first one, A is the correct answer, computation of magnetic field intensity. What is the direction of magnetic field intensity vector due to infinite long straight filament? So, radial, electrical, parabolic, circumferential. So the direction of magnetic field is circumferential. For that means magnetic field intensity vector due to infinite long straight filament. So for the study of Ampere's law, you must equate so many books. We must need to refer these books: Electricity and Magnetism by K.K. Tiwari, Electricity and Magnetism by Sehgal and Chopra, Electricity and Magnetism by Kare and Srivastava, College Physics Volume 2 by Sundarajan and others, Electrodynamics by B.B. Lord. So that means these are the books, reference books for the study of Ampere's circuital law or wave equation for field vectors. Thank you.